Hi students, good morning. Welcome to Real Numbers class 9th. I hope you are all following my videos. If you have any doubts, you can contact me through my number. Okay. And I hope I am explaining in easy way, so that if you have any queries, please contact me. Thank you. And when we come to the topic in real numbers, we are discussing of some properties of square roots. Yes, some of you facing problem in this concept itself. So that properties of some square roots, it is very easy. We must know just the what we have learned in 8th class, laws of exponents. If you know, these are very easy. See some formulas like this: a to the power of m into a to the power of n is equal to, these are laws of exponents. Laws of exponents: a to the power of m into a to the power of n is equal to a to the power of m plus n. Yes, a to the power of m by a to the power of n is equal to a to the power of m minus n. A to the power of m whole to the power of n is equal to a to the power of m into n. And a b whole to the power of m can be written as a power m into b power m. These are some of the laws of exponents, not all. Some of the laws of exponents I have considered what we are using to discuss these properties of some square roots. Let a comma b are positive real numbers. Positive real numbers. Because square root is defined for positive integers only in real number system, so that in the first one, root a into square root of a into square root of b. Yes, how to write this one? It is nothing but square root of a can be written as an exponential form a power 1 by 2 into square root of b can be written as b power 1 by 2. So that same power, so together if I write it, b whole to the power of 1 by 2. So if we remove 1 by 2, it can be expressed as square root of ab. Yes, so that square root of a into b can be written as square root of a into square root of b, where a comma b are positive real numbers. Already we defined here itself what are ab. Is it clear now? Similarly, second rule is quotient like that. See, root a by root b, root a by root b, same. Square root of a can be written as a power 1 by 2. Square root of b can be written as b power 1 by 2. So it is like a power m by b power m. Sorry, I didn't write. A power m by b power m can be written as a by b whole to the power of m, where b is not equal to 0. Yes? So that similarly, a by b whole to the power of 1 by 2. Together I can write. Yes? Now it can be written as square root of a by b. Instead of 1 by 2, we can express that in square root symbol. So from this, what do you understand? Square root of a by b can be written as square root of a by square root of b individually, where b is not equal to 0. This is second rule. A comma b are positive real numbers itself. Yes. Next, third one, finding product. See, third one is square root of a plus square root of b into square root of a minus square root of b. Yes? See, it is if you observe this form, it is like a plus b into a minus b formula or not. See, in a plus we have learnt a plus b into a minus b formula, a square minus b square. So that here what is a? Root a. What is b? Root b. So it can be written as root a whole square minus root b square root b whole square, square root of b whole square. We know that the square root of a is a power 1 by 2 whole square minus square root of b, b power 1 by 2 whole square. Now 1 by 2 into 2, 1, 1 by 2 into 2, 1, power to the power form. So remaining is a minus b. So this is another property. Root a plus root b into root a minus root b can be written as a minus b. Okay, is it clear? See, like this simple, these are very simple to understand. Okay, these are very simple to calculate, simplify also. Like this, if you simply will get the right hand side part. These properties we use to solve some problems in excess. Next, fourth one. Same, a plus root b into a minus root b. A plus root b into a minus root b. This is also in the form of, see, in the form a plus b into a minus b itself. Na? So we can write it as a square minus b square. What is the formula? A plus b into a minus b is equal to a square minus b square. Am I correct? Am I correct or not? Yes. So a square as it is minus square root b cancelled. What we have learned in the previous classes already. So it can be written as a plus root b into a minus root b. It can be written as a square minus b. A square minus b. Very simple, yes. Next, fifth one. A plus root a plus root b into root c plus root d. Root a plus root b into root c plus root d. Root a plus root b into root c plus root d. See, these are, here all are, these two are two irrational numbers adding, here also adding. If you multiply these square roots, we have to apply the formula. Which property we have to apply here to multiply? We have to apply distributive property. Yes, what is the distributive property? We have to left distributive or right distributive. A of b plus c is equal to a b plus a c is one distributive formula under addition, multiplication over addition. Or a plus b into c, right side, a c plus b is whatever may be, it is acceptable. Okay, now by using that, I am applying distributive property here to multiplying. So root a into this whole expression. What is the distributive property? A of b plus c can be written as a b plus a c. Okay, distributive property. So that root a into root c. Root a into this whole expression. Root c plus root d. Plus, here is plus, plus root b into this whole expression. Root c plus root d. Now if we simplify, we will get root of ac plus root of ad, because in first property itself we will end root a into root b can be as root of ab. So that root ac plus root ad plus root b into root c, root bc plus root b into root d, root bd, square root of bd. This is another formula to multiply to binomial sets, multiply to binomial sets or to binomial terms like this. Okay. So like this, these are the properties related to square roots. Okay, my children, understood?
Yes.
Now another formula, most important. Sixth one. Another formula, most important, sixth one. What is sixth formula? Root a plus root b whole square. Root a plus root b whole square. It is in the form of a plus b whole square. So that root a whole square plus root b whole square plus 2a. 2 into root a into root b. Yes? A square root cancel. A plus a also square root cancel. B plus 2 into root a into root b square root of ab. So this is also another formula. So square root of a plus square root of b whole square is equal to a plus b plus 2 into root of a. 2 into root of a. Okay. So like this we can solve. We can derive the formulas. We can write sixth one as like this also. If you write in the minus sign a minus b whole square, it can be written as root a minus root b whole square is equal to, it can be written as a plus b minus 2 root a b. Am I correct? Once you want to check out. Okay. Next, last but not the least, a plus b plus 2 into root a b. A plus b plus 2 into root a b. What is the square root of this expression? A plus b plus 2 into root of a b. What is the square root of this one? Already we derived this in sixth point now. So what can I write here direct? square root of a plus b plus 2 root a b can be square root of root a plus root b whole square. Square root of root a plus root b whole square. Now square root cancel. What is remaining? Root a plus root b. Yes? Same as epsilon. Like this, we derive formulas and these are some of the properties of related to square roots. Okay. I hope you all have understood these properties. Remember, read out many times, then we can remember long time. Okay. Thank you.